Berkeley's recreational sports facility, more than 2,800 people go to the gym every day. All that working out generates energy. So what if that energy could be captured? Two mechanical engineers launched a project last year to find out.
So what we have here, we have Kim pedaling on a conventional bicycle, and she's gonna kind of show us around this prototype of a mechanical to electrical energy conversion system. So she's pedaling, creating human power, and that mechanical energy is being converted into electrical energy through this friction drive generator. And that's being routed up through these wires to a power meter mounted on her handlebars. And right now it says she's generating about 20 watts. And all of that power is then being sent and stored into a battery right there. And we found out there was a company called ReRev that actually retrofits a lot of gyms, and they use elliptical machines because of just the way that they're created internally. They already generate a lot of power to create resistance for a user, so it's a lot easier to extract that and send it back to an electric grid. And so that's how our project started, looking at elliptical machines in the RSF.
I told her about a company that I knew that had already started trying to do this out of Florida, and she looked at their product and felt that Berkeley could do it better.
So over the summer, we conducted research on like how much energy could be generated from retrofitting ellipticals, and we found out it's not that much. So unfortunately, it's like only 10,000 kilowatt hours, which is enough to power a small house, but the RSF uses on the order of 1 million kilowatt hours. So it's only like about 1% of their energy usage. So energy generation isn't really our end goal with this project. We hope that by the end of it, we'll be able to retrofit ellipticals so that they do generate energy, but our main goal is to educate users.
So Maha and Kim have been taking their message on the road. Most recently, they demoed their project at the Recreational Sports Facility Sustainability Festival, Playgreen. This fall, they plan to install an educational kiosk in the gym's workout atrium, so members can make educated choices.
So it's very in keeping with our belief in supporting sustainability. Maha has a lot of energy. She's assembled a lot of students that seem very interested in this. So I'm excited to see what she can do with it.